Welcome to TCT Today. Now, here's your host, Julie Nolan.
Hey, thanks for joining us. Miss Lori Ray is with me. She's our partner relations, heads up that department. And so all the letters that you get or responses to emails, she's responsible to make sure that happens. That's you don't answer every one of them, of course.
Oh, my goodness. Too many to answer. But we try to respond to as many as possible and let people know that we are praying for them, that we do want to encourage them with the Word of God. Same thing with the Prayer Partner Ministry. We do answer all the calls, or we try to. And we just want to encourage them with the Word of God and pray for them. So, yeah, I get to be a part of that. And as I always say, I love it. I just loved working with our partners and working with our volunteers.
And one of our volunteers is here today,
that's
Pastor
right.
Clay Cofield, but it's Bishop.
Yes.
Sorry, Bishop Clay Cofield.
Yes, sir.
You've just come into town and kind of joined part of the TCT family, like immediately. We really appreciate it. You bring prayer partners. And you are on Ask the Pastor.
Yes,
and you travel. Tell him where you live and you travel, because he's also available to go to another one of our stations to help out.
Yes.
And you've offered to do that. So tell him about where you live
in
your church.
I live in Richmond, Virginia. Me, my wife, amen, my children, but that's a hey, baby. You got to say something to my wife.
Yeah,
amen.
Yes,
you're getting in trouble.
Right, there you go.
But I'm in Richmond, Virginia, and we are literally, we travel back and forth from Richmond to Harrisburg, Illinois. We have one church in Richmond, Virginia, and we have one church in Harrisburg, Illinois. It affords me the opportunity to be a part of such a great family at TCT. We have volunteers that come into the prayer room. God, we love the prayer room. Amen. And I mean, we're just encouraged just to be a part of the family.
Now, why did you pick to come to Harrisburg, Illinois?
Well, actually, I was born in Harrisburg.
Okay.
And my wife got a word maybe 2 years ago for me to come back to Harrisburg and begin to do ministry. But I hate cold weather.
You came the wrong place.
Yeah, you are.
That's exactly why I moved to the East Coast, because I didn't want to be, you know, back into the cold weather. But I yielded to the word of the Lord that my wife gave. And we came here and I actually did a revival. And out of the revival, the Lord opened a door. And when he opened the door, we opened Spirit of Fire Cathedral, Southern Illinois. And we've been going about 2.5 months strong, about 100 members. And
you know,
the Lord has been just moving. And the members love it because, you know, they have to come here. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
And be in the prayer room, because our ministry is seed sowing. And it's not just financial. It's your heart, your life, just your worship. Everything that we do ought to reflect, I think, the power of God. And the power of God ought to lead you not only to repentance, but ought to lead you to serve.
Mm-hmm.
And so coming here is just an awesome opportunity just to serve.
How can you pastor two different churches that are, I don't know, thousands of miles apart? I don't even know how the distance.
Yeah.
How in the world can you pastor two different churches that are so far apart?
Well, honestly, it's an easy question, because it's the people that I have under me, Minister Jesse White, Minister Michelle Shaw, Sheila Lindell, Tim Matthews.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, we have such a strong base of people that serve up under us. And then I have my lovely wife, Vanessa Cofield.
Mm.
Oh, my God. That woman is a prayer warrior. And because of my wife and the covenant agreement we have, she's able to cover the church in Richmond while I'm here. Or if she comes here and I go there, it's just an awesome opportunity.
Mm.
Amen.
That is awesome.
It is.
Now, we're going to have you share, so you need to stay tuned. He's going to share with us later. But Lori had the opportunity to go and interview the Newsboys last week. They were in Marion.
They were.
So tell us about it a little bit, and we're going to watch.
Oh, my goodness. You know, at my age, you would think that I wouldn't get giddy over things like that. But I tell you what, when you allowed me to go, I have to say that I actually got giddy. I love the Newsboys' music. Had never seen them in concert, and we had the opportunity to go to the Marion Civic Center and interview them. And I tell you what, so down to earth. They know that I was not a professional interviewer by any means, and yet they were so gracious. They have a lot of things coming up. They're actually on a Christmas tour, and I guess we want to go ahead and show them this interview. So watch this.
Oh, holy night.
We're
We're here in downtown Marion, Illinois. This is where the TCT Network is located, and right behind me is the historic Marion Cultural and Civic Center. Back in 1996, the building actually burned down, but the city came together and rebuilt. Tonight, we are very excited because Newsboys are in concert with us. But we're going to take you behind the scenes for an intimate discussion with them on what they do for Christmas and what they are expecting for 2011. Stay with us. I am so excited to be here with the Newsboys. And this is your first Christmas EP, right? Tell us about it. Why did you decide finally to do a Christmas project?
For me, especially, I've always been... I'm kind of a Christmas freak. I love Christmas music. I love the way the fire smells. It's cold outside. It's snowy around family, the tree, the pine, the pines and the tree. I mean, everything about Christmas is awesome. And then, of course, the greatest, of course, is the birth of our Savior.
I want to ask each one of you, what is your favorite Christmas song? Christmas carol, Christmas song?
Probably Silent Night.
Okay.
Probably my favorite song. It's the only quiet song I listen to all year.
We never really had much of a Christmas in Australia. It was Christmas, but it was like beach time, summer, completely different season, down the beach, barbecue, surfing. That's what Christmas meant to me. And so I remember seeing these Christmas cards with this big jolly fat guy with white stuff all around him. I couldn't relate.
To finish up on Christmas, tell me your favorite Christmas tradition.
Mine is with my family. My dad passed away a few years back, but we gathered around the tree and a lot of family time. Not too much TV watching time. We only had one TV in the house growing up. We were poor. And we watched, we opened up, you know, a few gifts here and there, and but talked a lot and just shared our hearts. And Dad would always have devotions on Christmas morning. Could open one gift, guys, until we had read the word, and then we got to eat the bird.
Pastor's kids are
yeah, and then, yeah.
Yeah, I think for me, probably Christmas Eve, it's like the one night of the whole year where my whole family's together. You know, all my aunts, uncles, cousins, kids, like everybody. Yeah.
I think for me, universally, as a kid growing up, it was about waking up Christmas morning at 4 a.m., still dark, waking mum and dad, jumping on the bed so we could rush down to the tree and open the presents. I think that's probably one of my fondest memories.
Yeah, I'd kind of have to agree with Jeff. Christmas Eve was always a big deal with our family, and that's when, still to this day, our whole family gets together.
Let's talk about Born Again. That came out in the summer of this year, is that
July,
right?
13th, July 13th, 2010.
What is so special about this project?
It's the first project, first new record from Newsboys with me as the lead singer, and two bands, Starworth bands in our industry for years, Newsboys and DC Talk. If you were a fan of one, you're probably a fan of the other. So the coming together of these two bands and a record coming out, it was just like, what is it going to sound like? You know, what do you do? How do you make it? So we threw away the formula. We let the art, you know, we followed the art. We chased the art because we knew that it had to be special, but also we didn't want to, you know, rely on old manna and go back to what we know would work. So we just took a lot of chances and went for it. And you're living in fear, having trouble even looking at me. Wishing they would give you more than words. Sick of people telling how it should be. What you download, where'd you get your info? You saw the hype show, now you're in.